Well, in Denver today, demonstrators gathered in their cars to call on government officials to cancel rent.
This protest was held in Lancaster.
In Albany Park.
People in Springfield gathered today.
In Harlem. Protesters lined up on the corner of the McCombs Dam Bridge.
A protest on Chicago's north side.
In Los Angeles.
In Boston, dozens of other tenants lining the street.
In Madison, demonstrators protested from their cars.
Dozens of people holding a car caravan protest in Knoxville.
The demonstration was part of a national push today.
They joined thousands. Dozens of others across the U.S.
More than 40 cities participated.
The Party of Socialism and Liberation.
Party for Socialism and Liberation inviting dozens to get in their cars.
Each honk a message to state leaders that people need help making rent.
Calling on the government to help bail them out.
Where demonstrators demanded that rents and mortgages be canceled.
As well as a cancellation of mortgages for small business and homeowners.
Protesters are also asking for zero debt accumulation from landlords.
Calling for all people to have safe homes during the health crisis.
To use empty apartments to house the homeless.
More resources for the homeless and undocumented residents.
They also want ICE detainees to be released.
Financial problems in the face of the coronavirus pandemic continuing to build.
And this weekend, frustration boiling over.
A sign handed on from the side of a car speaks to the fears echoed by so many around the state.
For many, rent is due next week.
May 1st is less than a week away, and with any calendar turn come bills.
In April alone, over 26 million people filed for unemployment across the nation, and one-third of tenants were unable to pay their rent.
Tens of millions of U.S. workers have lost their jobs, with record numbers of people applying for unemployment.
Organizers say it was a lack of government preparedness that led to the slow response to the virus, and workers shouldn't be the ones who are punished.
If we can't work, we can't pay. The dignity of our people is of the utmost concern.
Putting a moratorium isn't enough, because in a couple of months, people are going to have multiple months of rent due and they're going to not be able to pay it.
I don't know any average working person, certainly not myself, who can afford to pay 3 or 4 months of rent in one go.
We're all draining our savings pretty much. We're all like just trying to survive however way we can.
Millions and millions of people should not be worrying about potentially getting evicted.
The government can do more and they choose not to.
The U.S. government has trillions of dollars that it can give to multinational corporations. The people, workers, need bailouts as well.
Now is the time to fight back. Now we know that we have all the power in this country, that as soon as people have to stop going to work, the country stalls, that we as the working class have the power to change society.